Yes. Let's have a look. Need to switch it on, that's why.
Ladies and gentlemen, our bridal party has arrived. So thank you so much for organising yourself into that perfect positioning. I wonder how many bombs we're going to cop through the ceremony. Hopefully that's all. So I'm going to ask you just to stay seated for the arrival of our flower girls and the bridesmaids. And then when Lisa arrives, if you can, please be upstanding for her arrival.
Changing the world. Just one smile, change of mind, share the same soul. Oh, 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 share the same soul.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to this beautiful setting of Barwon Heads for the wedding ceremony of Marcus Alexander Peel and Lisa Marie Willis. Marcus and Lisa have spent lots of time planning this special day, and I'm thrilled that they've chosen me to be their celebrant. I know that they are both extremely thankful that you, their family and friends, are here to share their wedding joy today. Today we are all lucky enough to witness the love that Marcus and Lisa share as they make a long-lasting commitment to each other. And what an honour it is to have this opportunity to share their joy and happiness and support them with your best wishes as they begin their exciting journey as a married couple. Marcus and Lisa first met 4 years ago after matching on a dating app. Their conversations flowed naturally, and then they decided to meet in person because at the very least, Lisa was happy to score a free dinner. They enjoyed burgers, beers, and an impromptu game of Mario Kart, which Lisa won fair and square. Marcus's first impressions of Lisa were that she was intriguing, with a gorgeous smile, which grabbed his attention straight away. He was fascinated with her life experiences and stories of training dolphins and living on a boat. Lisa's first impressions of Marcus were that he was a typical Melbourne hipster, with his well-groomed beard, black skinny jeans and Converse shoes. He had a friendly, welcoming smile, and their conversations confirmed the hunch that Lisa had about him and about his personality. He seemed kind and caring with a warm, gentle nature. They hit it off, and they've been in each other's lives ever since. Lisa describes Marcus as loving, supportive, calm, and loyal. She admires how driven and hardworking he is. She thinks Marcus is a big softy with a big heart and also the greatest cat dad going around. Marcus describes Lisa as intelligent, witty, adventurous, and encouraging. He adores how kind, selfless, and supportive she is. Marcus also loves how organized and motivated Lisa is and how she makes his life much more enjoyable and rewarding. Since beginning their relationship 4 years ago, Marcus and Lisa have enjoyed many adventures together, including their incredible American trip, their holiday to Japan, where they stayed in Lake Kawaguchi, overlooking Mount Fuji, and also buying their first home together in Pasco Vale. Another special memory and a milestone in their relationship so far is Marcus's proposal. After 111 days spent in the Melbourne lockdown, Marcus surprised Lisa with a weekend away to their favourite Victorian coastal town here in Barwon Heads. Lisa packed her bags ready for a weekend of beachside relaxation, probably what we see here today. So she packed her bathers and thongs. So when Marcus let it slip that he had booked them a hot air balloon flight, they realised they needed to hit the shops to buy her some warmer clothes. The next morning at around 5:30 a.m, they were up high in the sky, and it was the perfect moment Marcus had been waiting so patiently for. He presented Lisa with a beautiful ring, which he had sneakily hidden in her handbag. And then he popped the question. Lisa replied with a big yes, and they were both thrilled. It's a special moment they'll never forget. No matter what, Marcus and Lisa always make time for each other, and they invest lots of love into their relationship, which they value more than anything else. They enjoy their spontaneous weekends away, with Daylesford being one of their favourite getaway destinations. They love to wine and dine on date nights, visiting new Melbourne restaurants as much as they can. They also like to relax by binge-watching their favourite reality TV shows and celebrating Sunday fun day with fun, random activities. Spending time with their family and friends and also spoiling their ginger fur baby Yoda are some of their favourite things to do. Marcus and Lisa love each other deeply, and they know that they can always rely on each other unconditionally. They've learnt many things together so far, and they know that whatever life throws at them, they're stronger together. And this has been proven through the hardships of the pandemic during the last couple of years. On a lighter note, they've learnt that Lisa should always consult with Marcus before adding to cart and pressing buy now on random purchases. And that Marcus should not attempt to fix ceiling fans or anything else around the house for that matter. Some things which Marcus has taught Lisa are the ins and outs of AFL football, that they don't need to share the same taste in music to enjoy concerts together, and to always Google coupon codes before finalising those online purchases. He's shown her the value of genuine friendship, and that true friends will always love and accept her for who she is. Lisa has taught Marcus the importance of communication in a relationship and has helped him to be more open to taking time out to recharge when it's needed. He's learned that they don't need a special occasion to treat each other with surprises, and this is something which he values in their relationship. Through Lisa, Marcus has developed a greater appreciation for nature, especially the coast. He's learnt that it's best to give Yoda what he wants, when he wants it, which includes sitting at the head of the table at dinner time. Lisa is thankful to Marcus for his constant support and acceptance, and how she can share anything with him without hesitation. They get along so well and share a relationship that comes so easily and naturally. Whether they are staying at home or off on an adventure, they always manage to have fun together. Lisa appreciates how Marcus shows her endless love and patience. He is caring and thoughtful, and he makes her morning coffee for her every day without fail. Lisa loves how they share so many core values in many aspects of their lives, particularly when it comes to their family. Their goals and ambitions align, and she is so excited for them to keep achieving their goals together and to tick off more things on their bucket list. Marcus feels lucky that he gets to experience a love that he has never known before, and he's fallen in love with Lisa's kindness, generosity, and her sense of humour. He is thankful that they share many similar passions and ambitions, and how they both like sharing new experiences. There is nothing pretentious about their relationship, and life is better when they are together. Marcus loves how Lisa is supportive and witty, bringing so much fun to his life. She makes him smile every day with her caring and truly selfless ways. Marcus cannot wait to spend the rest of his life showing Lisa how much he truly adores and appreciates her. She is a beautiful person who brings out the very best in him. Because of Lisa, he strives to be and do better. Marcus wants to make Lisa proud of him and the life they share, making sure that she is always happy within herself and their marriage. Lisa and Marcus want each other to be happy, and they will do whatever it takes to make that happen. In the future, they look forward to many more fun experiences and travel adventures, including another trip to San Francisco to visit family. They would like to relocate to Geelong to live closer to their family and friends, and down the track, experience human parenthood by adding some cute mini peels to their family. Lisa and Marcus want to lead a life filled with love, happiness, fun, and ambition, making the most of every opportunity and striving for the best life possible. They want to always love and support each other as much as they do now. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you've enjoyed hearing about Marcus and Lisa's journey in their relationship so far. My name is Lana Ryder. I'm a registered married celebrant and I'm duly authorised by law to solemnise marriages according to the law. Marcus and Lisa, before you join your marriage in my presence and in the presence of these witnesses, I am to remind you of the solemn and binding nature of the relationship into which you are now about to enter. Marriage according to law in Australia is the union of two people to the exclusion of all others voluntarily entered into for life. And I think I may have seen a big sense of relief then, Marcus. We know that they're thrilled to be getting married, and the wedding vows are an important part of the ceremony. They're promises which will bind them in marriage, and they have written some truly beautiful vows for each other, which they're going to share with each other right now. Still happy to go first?
Yeah. I call upon the persons here present to witness that I, Lisa Willis, take you, Marcus Peel, to be my lawful wedded husband. Marcus, little did I know that the day I got out of bed 4 years, 4 months, and 8 days ago would be the day that I would meet my soulmate. And now here we are today, and I couldn't be more excited to be marrying you and becoming your wife. Although I will try my best, I can't always promise to be the most perfect wife, but I can promise to love you through the good times as well as the bad and be there for you always. I promise always to try my best to make you laugh and make you feel better when you've had a bad day and not rub it in too much when the cats don't win. Now, promises are important and not to be made lightly, so I also promise to try to share the last piece of chocolate in the cupboard with you and refrain from hiding cards under the table during our games of Uno, Sushi Go, Exploding Kittens, Unstable Unicorns and Monopoly Bid. Life is so much fun with you and I love that. Today I vow to put every effort into ensuring our marriage is a happy one. I commit to doing all that I can to make our life together full of fun, adventure, laughter, and love. But most of all, I promise to love and appreciate you just as you are. I'm so lucky to have found you, and I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you. My life feels so complete when we're together, and I love that feeling. I love that you are my person and I am yours, and whatever door we come to, we will open it together. And together is my favourite place to be. Marcus, in you, I have found the love of my life and my closest, truest friend. I will continue to love you today, tomorrow, and all of the days that follow that forever and ever.
I was going to ask that question.
I call upon the persons here present to witness that I, Marcus Peel, take you, Lisa Willis, to be my lawfully wedded wife. Lisa, for the last 4 years, you have been my best friend, my greatest love, and the best thing to ever happen to me. From our very first date, I knew I'd met someone very special. You captured my heart with your smile, kindness, warmth, and humour. Being with you made me and continues to make me truly happy. I know how much we have grown together since those days in Brunswick East, achieving so much in such a short time frame. We've had our challenges, but I love how we've always been each other's biggest supporters. I promise to always have your back, as I know you'll always have mine. I promise to continue to be the best cat dad to Yoda, allowing a place in the bed and a chair at the dining table. I promise that you'll always have a cup of coffee waiting for you in the morning. I promise to continue to laugh with you through the fun times and be the calm through the tough times. I will forever count my lucky stars to have you as my wife. I will love you forever.
Beautiful. Wonderful. Well done. So good. Did such a good job.
I would now like to invite Ryan to please present the rings, which I believe he's been practicing a bit.
So I remember putting on about halfway and looking at Lisa. Lisa, I offer you this ring.
As
a symbol of my love. And commitment to
you. And commitment to you.
Marcus, I offer you this ring
as a symbol of my love.
And
everything we've promised today.
Marcus and Lisa have declared before us all that they will live together in marriage. They have vowed this commitment through sincere and genuine promises made to each other and through the exchange of rings. It is therefore my pleasure to declare Marcus and Lisa to be husband and wife. Marcus, you can kiss your beautiful bride. We are now going to sign our marriage certificates with our two witnesses, Ryan and Cassie. And we're going to ask our groomsmen just to make sure that everybody is loaded up with some confetti before we conclude the ceremony. So stay where you are, we'll be back in just a moment.
Thank you. just holds that.
Okay.
Be out of here.
Lisa, you hold that and talk to that mic. You can talk to me.
No, not right now.
She doesn't want to.
Gentlemen, before we conclude our ceremony, I have some special instructions from our newlyweds. Firstly, they would really like to get a beautiful photo heading back down the aisle with lots of confetti being tossed all around them, but not at them. So we ask you to please toss the confetti nice and high. And those people on the ends, no pressure. But we're relying on you to make sure that that confetti is tossed really well. Also, we would ask you to follow our bridal party out for a group photo before returning at 5 p.m. for some canapes and drinks, which Marcus and Lisa have organised for you. And the reception will begin formally at 6 p.m. Cherished family and friends, we witness Marcus and Lisa acknowledge their commitment to each other to make their marriage strong and everlasting. They bring each other incredible happiness and a willingness to share the success and the joy that life brings. Marcus and Lisa want to live a long, happy, supported life together, surrounded by their family and friends. They will continue to work together to achieve their goals and aspirations for themselves and each other, and create a wonderful life for their future. It is my great pleasure to present to you our newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Peel.
Yes, yes, yes.
Oh, that's